listening to the Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Kim Weisskopf's unmasking of a consumer fraud. The Mannequin Sham. Starring Lee Meriwether. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation, The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company, also by Sinoff, Tablets and Spray, Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, and International Harvester.
Today, the story of the Quinns, a likable couple who love each other. However, at the moment, they're living apart. Two people on the outs, looking for a way back in. And the route they're about to take is highly dangerous. More than a marriage, it could cost them their lives. Our story is called The Mannequin Sham.
I'm sorry I'm so busy, Lloyd, but you know how it is. You should know.
Honey, I want you to come home. As far as I'm concerned, our trial separation is over. I'll change. I love you.
Oh, Lloyd, you can't change. You're a detective. It's your work. Listen, I still love you. We just never should have gotten married.
Jay, how can you say that?
You were never home. Now I'm never home. We're like the proverbial two ships.
But I love you. Doesn't that mean anything?
Oh, Lloyd, you're so handsome when you get angry.
Oh, E.J.
Yes, Sarah.
Pamela Covington to see you, Mrs. Quinn.
Oh, send her in. You want to watch the girl you married at work?
No. When are you free?
Are you asking for a date?
E.J., this is cruel.
Dinner tomorrow at Archie's, 8 o'clock.
I'll make the reservation. What time should I call for you?
Come in, Miss Covington.
E.J., what time?
This is Mr. Quinn, my husband. He's a detective.
How'd you do?
Lloyd, I'll meet you at the restaurant, okay?
All right.
Goodbye. Well, Miss Covington, you're here about the modeling service, right?
That's right, Mrs. Quinn. I don't think they're on the level, and I was told that your organization checked into this type of thing.
Well, we're a consumer protection agency. If someone sold you a product or service and didn't deliver, then you came to the right place.
Well, that's what happened.
Well, tell me about it.
Well, one day, about 3 months ago, a woman came by my apartment and told me about the Margot Mandel Modeling Service and how they found jobs for models.
Were you a model?
No, I'm a bookkeeper. But anyway, she showed me all the literature about their courses on how to become a model and how anyone could be one if you signed up with them.
And you signed up?
Yeah.
How much was the tuition?
I paid $300 for classes in posture development and poise and movement.
Mm. You're not satisfied with the result?
Well, the trouble is that the classes haven't started yet. I've written to them, but they say they're waiting until the enrollment's better.
How much better?
They didn't say. Mrs. Quinn, up till now I've been able to get by on what I've saved. I'm not married, so my income was limited.
Was?
Yeah. I quit my job 2 months ago so I could devote full time to modeling.
Oh, I see. Well, Pamela, I think you have a case. We single gals have got to stick together, you know.
But Mrs. Quinn, wasn't that your husband I just met?
Yeah, we're separated.
Oh.
Now, before we start, I need some information from you. Would you care for more coffee, Miss Wood?
No, thank you, but I do have a few questions about your application.
Oh.
We need your full name for our record.
Oh, well, if you have to know, it's Elizabeth Jane. But everyone calls me E.J., even my husband.
Uh-huh. And you didn't put down your husband's occupation?
Oh, he's a salesman.
What does he sell? Does he work for a company?
I don't know.
You don't know?
He's a traveling salesman. He's always out of town. That's why we're separated.
I see.
My check is good. It's my own account.
I'm sure it is. And just as soon as it clears, we'll be in touch to let you know when classes start.
Oh, good. Oh, I can't wait.
You won't regret it, Mrs. Quinn. We at Margot Mandel have a reputation for being the best. I must be running along now. One last thing.
Yes, Miss Lee?
It's a little unusual that we're asked to come up to someone's home. How did you hear about us?
Oh, a dear friend of mine told me about you. I signed up for the same class as she did.
And who would she be?
Pamela Covington.
Margo.
Back so soon, Kirsten?
I have to see you about the woman who called, Mrs. Quinn.
Oh, I'll meet you in the office. All right, girls, everybody out of the water. It's time to go to work.
She's a cop, Margo. I just know it. That Covington girl's been talking.
Let her talk.
But the classes Mrs. Quinn signed up and paid.
Kirsten, we're going to have those classes.
We are?
Jim can arrange for them. He might even do the teaching. And you know that when Jim is the teacher, you don't forget your lessons.
Ooh, you paused for me. You shouldn't have.
They were alive an hour ago. You could have called.
Oh, honey, I completely lost track of time. I had to get these pictures developed.
What pictures? May I see them?
I don't want to bore you. They're for my work.
Ah, good evening, Jay.
Oh, hi, Archie.
Lloyd was afraid that you stood him up.
I'll lay off, will you, Arch?
Things just aren't the same around here since you two broke up.
Hey, what are you, a marriage counselor? Just take the order.
Okay. The Dover Soul is excellent tonight.
Lloyd, I want you to hear something.
Two Dover Souls, Arch.
Honey, listen.
Mrs. Quinn, modeling is really a state of mind. That's our philosophy at Margot Mandel. We've placed hundreds of girls throughout the country in fashion shows, commercials, magazine layouts.
Why did you turn it off?
Honey, you don't play a tape recorder in a restaurant.
It goes with the photographs.
What?
Remember that girl who came into my office the other day, just as you were leaving?
Vaguely, she was heavy set.
Yeah, that's right. Pamela Covington.
Let me see those pictures.
I'm doing some investigating for her. She signed up with the Margot Mandel Modeling Service.
Well, this isn't the girl I saw in your office.
Oh, I know. That's Miss Wolf, the same girl that's on the tape. She solicits for Margot Mandel. You know how it works, the door-to-door bit. They butter up unsuspecting women, then get them to sign up for the service. It doesn't even exist.
Where did you get these pictures?
I took them when Miss Wolf came to my apartment. I have the whole thing on tape. Of course, she doesn't know me.
Jay, you can't do that.
Well, why not? You do.
Yeah, but that's different. I'm a detective. EJ, this isn't good. This tape business especially. You know what kind of trouble that could get you into?
It's an obvious case of consumer fraud. Lloyd, I'm going to expose them.
Honey, there are other ways.
Don't try to talk me out of it.
Let me help. I don't want you risking your beautiful neck.
Lloyd, it's part of my job. Besides, you don't have time.
I'll make time. Starting right now.
Excuse me, you love birds. Telephone for you, Lloyd.
Ah, here we go again.
Hello. Oh, it's you. Oh. Is Arian's in town? Are you sure?
Archie, you better make that one Dover Soul.
Yeah, I got it. Thanks for the tip. Right. Arch.
You better make that one Dover Soul.
Oh, what? I'm sorry, honey. But
don't apologize.
Well, this one's the biggest fish in the ocean. Diamond Jim Nazarian's been underground for months.
You mean underwater, don't you?
Well, please don't be angry with me.
I'm too busy to be angry, Lloyd. I've got my work.
EJ, don't go through with this scheme of yours.
If you try to stop me, Lloyd, I swear I will sue you for divorce.
EJ?
What?
You're beautiful when you get angry.
Yes, sir.
Pamela Covington to see you, Mrs. Quinn.
Send her in.
Mrs. Quinn, you're wonderful.
Come on in, Pamela. Why, you look chipper today.
Oh, I am. I was just on my way to go shopping. I'm buying a new outfit with the last of my money.
But how can you afford it?
I got a job, thanks to you.
Thanks to me?
You saw the people at Margot Mandel, didn't you?
Yes, but I...
Well, they called me. I thought it was about the classes, but it's even better than that. They want me for a picture session tomorrow morning at the beach. Margot Mandel is going to be there in person.
That's wonderful.
I'd like to stay and talk, Mrs. Quinn, but the stores will be closing soon, and I need a red bathing suit for tomorrow.
A red bathing suit?
Oh, they said ox blood, but I looked it up, and it means red.
Well, I know just the place.
Mrs. Quinn?
Come on, I'm going with you.
do you mean, you lost Nazarian? He didn't just vanish. Well, that's great. So we got the car he abandoned. Big deal. I don't suppose you got the registration there. What's the name on it? Margot Mandel? The address. Meet me there in 15 minutes.
Listen, Margot, forget this Quinn dame. The heat's on.
You're telling me? That was my car you were seen in. Well, you're safe out here. There's not another house around for miles.
You don't seem to understand. I'm wanted for murder.
I understand our deal, Jim. I pay you for muffle. Tomorrow morning, those two women will be out here expecting to have their picture taken. All you've got to do is shoot them. Hello?
Margo, this is Kirsten. Two detectives were here looking for you. I told them the car was stolen, like you said to.
Well, then what's the problem?
As they were leaving, one of them called the other by his name.
So?
It was Quinn.
Consumer Guardians, may I help you?
Is E.J. Quinn there?
Mrs. Quinn left for the day.
You know where she went? This is her husband.
She didn't say. Did you try her apartment?
There's no answer.
She left several hours ago with Miss Covington.
Did you say Covington?
Yes. I think they were going shopping for bathing suits.
But if you hear from her, have her call me. No, wait. She's mad at me. Tell her that Margot Mandel works with Diamond Jim Nazarian and to stay away from both of them. Did you say bathing suits?
Yes, I did.
Thank you. You've been most helpful.
Margot, I still don't like it.
You don't have to like it. Just do it. No one will see or hear a thing. Disposing of the bodies won't be a problem.
You got it all figured out, don't you?
What has to be, has to be.
Remember, I'm the one who sets you up with this operation, madam.
Don't be cute.
You had a good thing going. Why did you have to get greedy?
I needed more girls. We were expanding. The phony classes were an afterthought. You know, that Quinn woman isn't bad looking. Too bad she had to get nosy. Well, they should be changed into their swimsuits by now. I'll get them.
I'm almost dressed, Mrs. Quinn.
Oh, just take your time, Pamela.
Looking for something, Mrs. Quinn?
Yes, a safety pin. I'm not quite as big as my top.
I have one. Turn around. I'll do it for you.
Oh!
How do I look?
Magnifique, Miss Covington. I'm sorry, Mrs. Quinn. Did I stick you?
Is this yours, Mrs. Quinn? I found it in the dressing room. It must have fallen out of your purse.
Bring it here, dear. Oh, how cute. A teeny little camera.
Is that what it is?
Miss Covington, the photographer is waiting down the beach. Why don't you go on ahead? Mrs. Quinn and I will be along shortly. Where did you get this adorable little camera? Let's see. How does it work? Oh, my. I seem to have broken it. Oh, well, I can have it repaired. I'll put it in the drawer for safekeeping. Yes, a tape recorder.
Miss Mandel, I can't explain.
All right, lady, who are you?
All right. I'm a consumer advocate. You people are duping the public.
Is that so?
I don't think you're really a modeling agency.
Does your husband know you're here, the detective?
No, he doesn't, because how did you know he's a detective?
It's a crying shame he doesn't know, Mrs. Quinn, because when we're through with you, you're going to wish he did.
That's it, ladies. Back up a little more. A little further.
But we're in the water as it is.
Just do as he says, Fatty.
Fatty?
I'm sorry I got you into this, Pamela. By any chance, can you swim?
Yeah, what's going on? What's he doing? What is that? A gun?
Oh, rats, it is.
Marco, I can't go through with this.
Go on, Jim. Shoot them.
What's that? There's a motorboat coming.
Give me the gun.
Come on, Pamela, let's swim for it.
I'm getting out of here.
Jim, come back here.
Give up, Nazarian. You're surrounded. Throw down the gun.
It's Lloyd.
That's far enough, Miss Mandel.
Archie was right about the Dover soul. Mm-hmm. It was great.
Have you noticed he's been beaming all night?
Well, he likes us, honey. And we did come in together. Maybe now that Nazarian and the Mandel woman are behind bars, we can come here more often?
Maybe.
If you're through playing detective, you might even consider moving back in. I want you to.
You know, I didn't do too badly for my first time. I had the goods on them. If Margot hadn't found the camera and the tape recorder, I could have brought them in myself. Actually, Lloyd, you know, you butted in.
DJ, if I hadn't butted in, I might be a widower.
Oh, you're exaggerating.
Oh, you're lucky. Nazarian abandoned the car registered to Margot Mandel. If there hadn't been sand in it and a receipt for repairs, I wouldn't have found the service station, the beach house, or you in time.
Oh, I would have gotten away somehow.
EJ, come home, please. I miss you.
Oh, Lloyd.
Hate to break this up, but you got a phone call.
Tell him I'm not here.
Sorry, Lloyd, it's not for you.
What?
Oh, thank you, Archie. Hello. Yes, this is Mrs. Grimm. Well, of course I'd be interested. That's my job. Tell me, Mrs. Cummings, is this company guaranteed what? Oh, and they didn't. Oh, and you think they ought to be investigated?
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of Zero Hour.
The Mannequin Sham is an original radio drama by Kim Weiskopf. Lee Meriwether was heard as E.J. Quinn. Featured in the cast were Les Tremaine, Catherine Brody, Rhoda Williams, Joe DeSantis, and Ann Whitfield. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Collis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman. Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.